Good morning. Welcome to worship on this 17th Sunday after Pentecost, where we continue through to the end of our lectionary year of Luke. This is our baptism boy. You can tell he's glad to be here. And we're glad to have you here, Rogan Cole Pilarski. Yeah. We continue through the exquisite parables of Jesus in Luke's gospel. In these trying times, we need to know that the smallest acts of kindness, the smallest acts of love, even as small as a mustard seed, can make a difference. You will be hearing more about the fall campaign from your stewardship team soon. For now, just make sure that you have November 20 on your calendars. This is the designated Sunday for Commitment Sunday, where everyone will be able to bring their commitment cards forward for 2023 during the worship service. So stay tuned for more information from your Christ Lutheran Stewardship team in the days and weeks ahead. If you are a visitor with us, we say a special word of welcome to you, whether you are online with us or in person, whatever brings you here. Wherever you are on your faith journey, we say welcome to Christ Lutheran Church in Blaine, Minnesota. Again, welcome to worship. And at this time, I would like to invite Rogan Cole Pilarski to come forward for the sacrament of baptism and to bring his sponsors and his family with him. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, I ask parents and sponsors, do you desire to have Rogan baptized into Christ? If so, answer altogether, we do.
We do.
As you bring your child to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with him among God's faithful people, to bring him to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach him the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place in his hands the Holy Scriptures, and to nurture him in faith and prayer, so that Rogan may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help Rogan grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, answer together, parents and sponsors, we do.
We do.
And people of God, do you promise to support Rogan and pray for him in his new life in Christ? If so, answer together, we do.
We do.
Congregation will please rise and join in the profession of faith. I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God, the powers of this world that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God? I renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. The congregation may be seated. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that the one washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Okay, so if you can hold him a little bit forward over the water. Okay, oh, Mom. You gonna be okay? Here's the water. Remember we talked about this? Here it is. Ready? In the name of the Father. Yeah, and of the Son. Water. And of the Holy Spirit. So bad. There we go. Okay. There you are. And you get to hold this. Do you want to? Okay. All right. Rogan, we rejoice in your baptism. You belong to Christ in whom you have been baptized. Alleluia. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Rogan Cole with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Rogan. Child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. Amen. So we light a candle on this day from the baptism candle where our children at Christ Lutheran are baptized. And if it is possible a year from now that you can still find this candle, you can take it out and light it. And then every year as Rogan grows, you can light it again for him and tell him about this day, that he is a baptized child of God, that he is loved unconditionally by God, and that wherever he goes, as he grows, God will never let him go. So Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. So together, congregation, we welcome Rogan. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. Okay, if you can hold this. I'm going to see if Rogan will let me take him for a little walk. Should we take our little walk now? Okay, we'll take a quick walk and then we'll bring you back, okay? Let's try it. So, congregation, I present to you the newest member of Christ Lutheran Church, Rogan Cole Polarski.
Call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where fear may fail, and there I find stand. I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. May fail and fear surround me. You'll never fail and you won't start now. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine.
Spirit, leave me where my trust is borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders.
Let us pray. Benevolent, merciful God, when we are empty, fill us. When we are weak in faith, strengthen us. When we are cold in love, warm us, that with fervor we may love our neighbors and serve them for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Come, thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace.
mercy never ceasing. Call for songs about His praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mountain fixed upon it, Mount of Thy redeeming love. I was lost in utter darkness till You came and rescued me. I was bound by all my sin when Your love came me free. Now my soul can sing a new song. Now my heart has found a home. Now Your grace is always with me, and I'll never be alone. Come Thou fount, come Thou King, come Thou precious Prince of Peace. Hear Your bride, to You we sing. Come Thou fount of our blessing. Oh, to grace how great a debtor daily I'm constrained to be. Let Thy goodness like a by my wandering heart to Thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Is my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for Thy courts above. Come Thou fount, come Thou King. Come Thou precious Prince of Peace, hear Your bride, to You we sing. Come Thou fount of our blessing. Come Thou fount, come Thou King. Come Thou precious Prince of Peace, hear Your bride, to You we sing. Come Thou fount of our blessing.
Congregation, will please rise. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is eager to forgive and who loves us beyond our days. Amen. Dear friends, together let us acknowledge our failure to love this world as Jesus does. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that sin still has a hold on us. We have harmed Your good creation. We have failed to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with You. Turn us in a new direction. Show us the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. Beloved of God, our sins are forgiven and we are made whole. God points the way to new life in Christ, who meets us on the road. Journey now in God's abiding love through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our first reading today comes from the Old Testament book Habakkuk, from the first and second chapters. The oracle that the prophet Habakkuk saw, O Lord, how long shall I cry for help, and You will not listen? Or cry to You violence, and You will not save? Why do You make me see wrongdoing and look at trouble? Destruction and violence are before me. Strife and contention arise. so that the law becomes slack and justice never prevails. The wicked surround the righteous, therefore judgment comes forth perverted. I will stand at my watchpost and station myself on the rampart. I will keep watch to see what he will say to me and what he will answer concerning my complaint. Then the Lord will answer me and said, write the vision, make it plain on tablets so that a runner may read it. For there is still a vision for the appointed time. It speaks of the end and does not lie. If it seems to tarry, wait for it, and it will surely come. It will not delay. Look at the proud. Their spirit is not right in them, but the righteous live by their faith. The word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you've got. There's honey in the rock. Thirsty for the living well, only you can satisfy. The sweetness at the mercy seat, I taste it, it's not hard to see, only you can satisfy. There's honey in the rock, there's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock, there's honey in the rock. Freedom where the spirit is, bounty in the wilderness, you will always satisfy. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I everything I need you've got. Is honey in the rock, purpose for your plans. There's power in the blood, healing in your hands. Started flowing when you said it is done. Everything you did is enough. I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, you keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep praying. Keep moving, I keep praising, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you've got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hand. Sudden flowing when you said it is done. Jesus, you are living now. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock.
The Holy Gospel for this day comes to us from Luke, the 17th chapter. The apostles said to the Lord, increase our faith. The Lord replied, if you had faith the size of a mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Who among you would say to your slave who has just come in from plowing or tending sheep in the field, come here at once and take your place at the table? Would you not rather say to him, prepare supper for me, put on your apron and serve me while I eat and drink? Later you may eat and drink. Do you thank the slave for doing what was commanded? So you also, when you have done all that you were ordered to do, say, we are worthless slaves. We have done only what we ought to have done. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Please join me in a word of prayer. Our loving and gracious God, you entrust your beloved children to us, that we might instill confidence and faith in them, even if only the size of a mustard seed. As these days of a new school year continues, be with children, parents, and teachers. Give them the assurance of your presence with them. Amen. While doing research on the impact of inner-city schools on child development, a sociologist stumbled on a surprising discovery, quite by accident. He noticed that a number of unlikely young adults who had gone on to college, on to law school, on to medical school, and the like, had come out of the same area of Pittsburgh's inner city. These were young people who had everything in life stacked against them. Curious, the sociologist decided to pursue his findings further. Investigating and following up with these young adults, he traced the origins of these young people not only to the same part of the city, the same neighborhood, and to the same school, but to the one middle school teacher that they all had had in common. When the sociologist located the school and stopped by to interview the teacher one day after school, he asked her what she had done to make the educational and professional accomplishments of these young people even possible. What philosophy of education, what methodology, what pedagogy could this be taught and replicated in elementary, middle, and secondary education methods classes? What method exactly did you put to work in your classroom? He wanted to know. The teacher thought for a long moment. The sociologist was ready with notebook in hand. She reflected a bit more, and then she said rather matter-of-factly, "Oh, I just love them." The parable of the mustard seed is often construed to be about something that a mature believer holds inside of them, something they know, understand, believe. But what if we understood this from the standpoint of grace? A great love given to us unconditionally by God to then give to others, especially to our children, who can only know that they are loved, that they are valued, that they can move mountains, they can uproot mulberry trees by being loved by us. Last week, we heard from our friends from Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge about what a radical intervention of love can mean in a single life. And when that love then is passed on to others, it takes on a ripple effect that can transform, empower, and yes, move mountains, even if it is just a small bit of love, as small as a mustard seed. Every now and then, I like to stop back at my daughter's elementary, middle, or high school just to say thank you to a teacher or to ask, how did you know how to do that when they were 13? Or just thank you for being there in those days. The last time I stopped by our former middle school, our music teacher was telling me about a study that she had read recently that demonstrated that in our culture, the average teenager, the average American teenager receives, on average, 47 negative messages a day. About being a teenager. Messages from advertising, from the internet, from social media, Instagram, TikTok, from the news, from their peers at school, in the hallways, in the classroom, walking home, stopping at CVS or Walgreens, even when they're with their friends, which means that they need at least one word of affirmation and encouragement every day to counteract all of the negatives. In a Lutheran Listening Post survey, teenagers themselves, when interviewed and asked about what was most painful or difficult about being a teenager, said some surprising things. Although there were a few items that rose to the top, far and above the expectations and stress of grades and academic performance, far and away from having a curfew enforced with consequences, far and above the worry over sports and drugs and alcohol in school, was this: to be put down in front of my friends. To be put down in front of my friends. Before this autumn season then is over, we would do well to give thanks again for educators and coaches and teachers who invest in our young people, who devote their lives to discerning how best to be there for them, who understand that even the smallest bit of love, as small as a grain of mustard seed, can move mountains in any one child's life. But what about the church? You ask, what about the role of religion in young people's lives? Where does that come in? Before my confirmation students over the years would leave home for college or military service or wherever they were going, I would often give them a copy of this little paperback by Rabbi Harold Kushner entitled simply, Who Needs God? The rabbi opens this little book with a story of a young adult in his congregation who has come back for Thanksgiving vacation after having left for college to meet with the rabbi because he wants to tell him that he no longer believes in organized religion. That's okay. I remember old Pastor Pastor Berg down at Augustana Lutheran Church used to say that the cry of a child is more music to the angels in heaven than the quiet snoring of 100 saints. I'll get back to my little book. So the rabbi, the college student comes back to tell the rabbi that he is no longer interested in organized religion. And that's okay, the rabbi says back to him, you've come to the right place. You can just look at my desk if you want to see what disorganized religion looks like. The college student was quite serious about this conversation, however. I believe in God, he told the rabbi. I believe in being kind to people, treating them right, not hurting them. I believe in trying to make the world a better place, but I don't see why you need churches and synagogues, fancy buildings that are always looking for money. I don't see why you need professional clergy, nothing personal, rabbi, prayer books, organized services, rules and rituals that nobody understands. I don't see why you need so many different religions all arguing with each other. Why isn't it enough to just tell everyone to be nice to each other? Rabbi Kushner goes on to say that he wrote this little book for this student, Paul, and the many others like him who have asked similar questions. Intelligent, thoughtful people that he has met on his travels on airplanes, journalists, radio talk show hosts, strangers who struck up a conversation, all who had trouble believing that religion could be important to anyone in modern times. And why does the rabbi conclude that religion is as important as believing in God and just being kind? The thesis of this little book is that there is a kind of nourishment our souls crave. Even as our bodies need the right foods, sunshine, and exercise, without spiritual nourishment, our souls remain stunted and underdeveloped. But most importantly, Rabbi Kushner worries in this little book about the congregants in his synagogue like Paul. He worries about what will happen when life takes a turn for the worse. In the life of every student that leaves home, a rabbi knows that sooner or later, a disappointment, a failure, a struggle, a loss will come to every life. And without a framework of faith, without, for example, the lament of a familiar psalm, a phrase from the liturgy, O God, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Without the prayers that lift the spirit heavenward in the context of a community, especially one back home that loves them. The rabbi does not know how a young person or a middle-aged person, for that matter, will make it through. But if their church or synagogue or mosque loves them, in those moments, he says, they will know that God loves them too, and that God will be there for them. What a beautiful send-off that the Christ Lutheran Welka Group did for your seniors this year. And we can only hope that now, wherever they are, they will know that God is with them. Sort of like one of the students in one of my former congregations who came back from college at Thanksgiving and told me how when she first got to college, her roommate didn't arrive for several days. So she spent the first nights going to sleep, staring up at a blank ceiling with this simple prayer, Okay, it's you and me, God. You're the only one here that I know. I just love them, the middle school teacher said so matter-of-factly. I just love them. It seems like such a small thing, so insignificant. And yet it truly is magnificent what a tiny bit of love can do. Put your trust in small things. The gospel writers remind us again and again, small acts of kindness, small bits of love, and they will grow large enough like the branches of a mulberry tree that receives the birds of the air, providing refuge and shelter, protection and comfort. It is the least that we can do for our children, because it is the most of what God has already done for us. Amen.
Everybody falls sometimes, gotta find the strength to rise from the ashes and make a new beginning. Anyone can feel the ache, you think it's more than you can take, but you're stronger, stronger than you know. Don't you give up now, the sun will soon be shining. You gotta face the clouds to find the silver lining. I've seen dreams that move the mountains, hope that doesn't ever end, even when the sky is falling. Broken hearts become brand new. That's what faith can do. It doesn't matter what you've heard. Impossible is not a word. It's just a reason for someone not to try. Everybody's scared. They decide to take that step out on the water, but it'll be alright. Life is so much more than what your eyes are seeing. You will find your way if you keep believing. I've seen dreams that move the mountains, hope that does.
Congregation, will please rise. As scattered grains of wheat are gathered together into one bread, so let us gather our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of God's good creation. We pray for your holy church in every place and for those who serve following the example of Christ. Help them to live by faith and walk by the light of your gospel. God of grace, hear our prayer. For parts of the world ravaged by natural disaster, relieve those affected by floods, wildfires, droughts, earthquakes, tornadoes, and hurricanes. God of grace, hear our prayer. For every nation and for those entrusted with authority, grant our leaders self-discipline in all things and inspire them with love for your people. God of grace, hear our prayer. For victims of violence, abuse, and neglect, heal those who have been harmed and protect those who are vulnerable. For all who are sick, especially in our midst, we pray for Barb Wielander, Kimberly Dahleen, David Voss, Nancy Olson, Roger Nelson, Lillian Haugen, and all those we now name before you in the silence of our hearts. God of grace, hear our prayer. For this and every congregation, rekindle your gifts within your people and inspire councils, committees, and individuals to plan and work together that all may know your love. God of grace, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving that you have abolished death and for the saints who have died, bring us all to eternal life with you. God of grace, hear our prayer. Gathered together in the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, gracious God, we offer these and all our prayers to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. And now hear the words of institution. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The table is set. All are welcome. You may be seated.
Whatever may pass and whatever lies.
reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship your holy name. Strength is failing, the end draws near, and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
God, who gives life to all things and frees us from despair, bless you with truth and peace. And may the Holy Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow. God's love will lead me through. You
are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you.
My lighthouse.
In peace with Christ beside you. Thanks be to God.
Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Fire before us, you're the brightest.
Show up.
Save to show up.